Hey guys, my name's JJ and I've made this video resource as a guide to help small goalkeepers like myself make the transition to 11-a-side football. Making the transition from goals that are 8 feet tall and 24 feet wide might be scary, especially if you're short. Confidence is such a key part of goalkeeping and something you might really lack if you're a short goalkeeper like myself. In this video, I aim to give you some helpful tips and advice that might help and aid that transition to 11-a-side football. For this teach, I aim to cover catching, crossing and communication. These are all skills that are really important to have as a goalkeeper. You're not at a disadvantage being short.
Firstly, let's look at the W hand catch. This is the most common technique for catching and it's great to use for all shots not kicked straight at you and for any high shots. Approach this catch nice and relaxed, knees bent and hands around chest height. When making the catch, shape your hands like a W. This is so your thumbs stop the ball slipping through your grasp. Here's a few shots of it in action. And now from a side-on angle. Next, let's look at the torso catch. This is a great catch to use if the ball is hit into your body, above your knee and below your neck. Approach this catch like you did to the first, however with this, you allow the ball to hit your chest. As soon as the ball makes contact with you, wrap the ball tight with both arms around it. Here's a few shots of the torso catch. And again, a side-on view. Scoop and collapse. This is useful for shots below knee height and any shot bouncing towards you. When used correctly, it's the safest of the three. When performing this catch, kneel down on one leg pointing inwards, which will act as a barrier if needed. With your palms upwards, gather the ball and quickly scoop into your chest. Allow your momentum to fall forwards and onto the ball. Here, we can see the scoop being used in real time. Again from the side. Lastly, crossing. No matter how small you are, by being able to use your hands, you automatically have a big advantage over the attacker. So help your team and get used to coming for crosses. For crossing, there are two key points. Firstly, when jumping towards the ball, you should have the knee of your leading leg in the air. This both protects you and puts strikers off coming towards you. Secondly, you should call keepers nice and loud well in advance. This lets your defence know you're coming and allows you to command your box well. Good communication is one of the most important skills to have. As a goalkeeper, you see everything and so are best positioned to organise your team. It should always start from you. This is a really key skill to have, one that I can't stress enough. When your team is defending, you need to be watching over all the attacking players to make sure they're all being marked. The key to good communication is quick, loud, concise commands. For example, John, left shoulder, if there's a player unmarked to the left of your defender. Or simply, get out, if you want your defence to push up the field. A loud, talkative goalkeeper reassures defenders that they are being well looked after and that things are under control. This puts them at ease and improves team mentality, as well as reducing the chances of a mistake. It is your job not just to organise the defence, but to make sure that midfielders drop back to mark players too, and also to organise players during corners and free kicks. Practice. Next time you're in training, practice giving your defence clear and quick commands. If you're just shouting lots of words at them, it might confuse them, so make sure to be as concise as you can. In summary, I've covered catching using three different techniques: the W hand catch, which is the most common, the chest catch, great for balls hit at your torso, and the scoop catch, great for shots along the floor and bobbling shots. Next, crossing. You should shout "keepers" so your defenders know it's your ball, and you should jump with a knee in the air to protect yourself and put the strikers off attacking the ball. Remember, it doesn't matter how small you are, by being able to use your hands, you have the advantage, and you should be confident coming to win those crosses. Lastly, communication. The key to good communication is being loud, clear, and concise. Don't let your size knock your confidence, because that is so important as a goalkeeper. Hopefully with these tips, it will improve your game, and remember to practice. Thanks for watching.